we need an input function that will return the command to be executed. If this were an interactive program, that is, if we would run this in a console on our own machine, this is the command to be used so we could interact with it. This is what you can use on your own machine in order to get your debugger to work. In this web IDE, however, such an interactive program does not work, so we need to simulate this. So what we have here is, I have set up a list of predefined commands to execute. In here this would be step, step, and quit. And we're using the method pop of 0 to return the first element of the command list, and at the same time also to remove the first element from the commands list. So the command that's now missing is quit, so we have to add this. If we have a command that starts with quit, we call sysexit of 0, meaning that our debugger exits. All is set now. Initially, we do not step through the program, but we have a breakpoint in line 9 and in line 14. We want to execute three commands, step, step, and quit. What should happen is that execution is normal until it reaches line 9, then we step through two more lines, and then we quit the program. Let's see whether this actually works. And indeed, it has worked exactly as we wanted. First, we reach line 9, then we step, we reach line 11, then we step, we reach line 13, and then we quit, and this is precisely the output we would have expected.